again. So you've just caught me as I'm smelting up some of that clay, and also I am about to make... I'm going to starve to death, aren't I? So I need to make some food. So actually, let's also just do this pretty quickly. I'm getting really tired of doing this though, so I think I will try and automate that today, if at all possible. Which I think it is. Anyway, so food. What can I make for food? Now you'll notice here that I've been making stuff like this pretty often, and I think I'll make some more of that. You might have been able to guess what it is. I think I have enough stuff for it here. I can't remember exactly, but I think this is it. That's almost the wrong thing. How do I make butter? It's silken tofu and a saucepan. Okay, which I have here. Cool. So let's put the pot away and do the exact same thing, but with what? Oh, it's silken tofu, not the silly me, which I also have. So that's good. So if I put that away, and boom, 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 butter. Put the saucepan away. Come over, ha! Make some delicious grilled cheese sandwiches. Is that all you make? Oh, what did I run out of? I ran out of cheese. No, what did I run out of? I ran out of toast. And that's understandable, actually, because I don't have any bread left, I think. Something else I want to do pretty quickly is get my... get a little greenhouse set up on the go. Oh, hello. Oh, that's just annoying. Let's see if we can do it this way again. Oh, man. See, when you record, you lose all sense of, like, ability. So... I'm going to do a little bit of a tour, so let me just be right back, and I'm going to get up and fly and show you my plans. Okay, so here we are at the top of Tower B. It's coming nighttime, so I can't mosey about too much, but you'll see we've lit up a really big area to the east. So I want to equalize, I want to make it just a large area to the west and south and north. So, mob tires are here. I want to make this a little oasis. So I'm planning on making a lot of this all dirt. Now I'm hoping I don't have to make a barrier of some sort of wall, because I'm hoping that basically just the light will stop enough stuff spawning. But if it doesn't, it doesn't, and I'll have to make one. Towards the back, which I'd hope you might have got a better view of, because I hoped not to like mess that up so badly. But towards the back, what I'm hoping to do is put up like a farm and a greenhouse. And I'm debating a couple of different designs. I don't know how I want to do it. I kind of like the idea of having like a farm be like have lots of basement areas and stuff, but I also do like having, I honestly don't know how to do it. I kind of like an idea of an orchard with lots of different types of trees. I kind of really want to have one of pretty much every kind of tree and every kind of crop and stuff. And I don't know if I should be doing that in like a sort of industrial type complex, or kind of make it look more natural, or maybe a bit of both. I don't really know. Leave your comments and suggestions in the video description, and I'll have a think about it, because I'd really appreciate that, guys, to be honest. So yeah, that's one thing we've got going on. In fact, actually, I could have used it for this, but I didn't, because I'm thirsty already. But I'm thinking of maybe making one of these guys, the building guide. Actually, they're really cheap to make. I didn't realize how cheap they were to make. Interesting. So yeah, I think I might do that. So that would be cool. I remember before I needed obsidian for something, but I can't honestly remember what it is. So I'm going to ignore that until it becomes an issue. Let's go down and see how my two things. Let's get some water, and let's see how the etching acid's getting along. I think it should be pretty much done now, so that's cool. This would be a lot easier to do, or to like put up with, if there was a way to like speed put something into your inventory. I think anyway, it would be. Let's just quickly fill that up again. Not into your inventory, into your crafting grid. But anyway, let's have a quick look at how the etching is done. I think, hold on, not the etching, we did that. How this thing is getting along. Okay, cool. Is that... We still have to throw it in etching acid, do we? Okay, so now it has 100% success rate. Okay, I don't quite understand how that works, but what we'll do is I'll go make some more etching acid. So be right back, guys. I am out of spider eyes because I ate them all, presumably. So we need to get some spiders. I'm trying to look to where I can see spiders. I think there's some up there. On the mini map. There's not too many around here. There's one. Okay. There's a couple. Okay, that's good. That's good. That's good. That's good. Right, let's kill this guy. Come on, die already. And then we can kill these spiders. Come on. Oh god. The last thing I want to do is die out here. But I don't think I will. I just want spider eyes. Come on. Okay, one. I just need two, so it shouldn't be too hard. I want to try and avoid that tough spider. Yeah, okay. Here we go. Oh, not a time for a lag spike. Not a time for a lag spike. I get it all the time around about this area. It must be something to do with either the micro blocks. Well, I can only presume it's to do with the micro blocks because there's not an awful lot else in the world that could be causing me that much lag. But I like the micro blocks so much. Okay, so two spider eyes. Bucket of water should be pretty easy to get. Yeah. Two spider eyes, two plastic, two gunpowder, and two brains. Okay, so water. Thank you. And another etching acid should be straightforward to get. I think that's how you do it, isn't it? Let's just doubly make sure. Yep, all of that's that. And it doesn't need much stuff, so again, should just be a case of all of this stuff going in, which it almost has. Oops. Did that all go in there already? See, whilst the pipes, when they're opaque, are a lot easier to, like, understand, they're also a lot slower, and it's difficult to, not understand, easier to make, they're also a lot slower, so that's less than ideal. It's not pulling it out or something daft, is it? Because it should still be used for etching acid. It's still got enough pressure. Is that everything? I can't see the zombie brains in there. There we go. Okay, and that should be it. Come on now. What else is there? Gunpowder. Oh, okay, the gunpowder isn't in there either. Okay, here we go. Come on. I think, did that just instantly form and get instantly sucked out? I hope so. There we go. Okay, now I have no idea how this works. So if I make a mess of this, I apologize. But let's just try that and then try throwing it in there. And I mean, I don't even know what it looks like. hold on, no, wait a minute. Oh, hold on. Maybe I didn't even need to do that, did I? Let me just think. Okay, machine does that. Yeah, I need an unassembled PCB. Do I definitely need these for that? Do I definitely need these for that? I think I do, don't I? Ow, ow, ow. I think I definitely need... Oh, no. Wait a minute. That had a percentage to it. So maybe not. That had 22% assembly to it. Because I don't think I need necessarily... Maybe I do. Because this looks all expensive too. Anyway, let's see. Maybe the quest book has a guide. Okay, let's okay, claim that. Thank you very much. Okay. If you think this whole process is overly complex and tedious, there's an alternative. That said, your first few... Hold on, blah, 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 blah. Okay, right, let's read this. So you now have an empty PCB. What do you do with it? Simple, you drop it in a hole and pour etching acid over it. It takes 5 minutes to process, though. So you're going to want to pick it up a few times, both to check on the progress and to make sure it doesn't despawn. Okay, that makes sense. If you think this process is easy, there's an alternative. That said, your first few PCBs will need to be made by hand, so to speak. Okay. As an aside at this point, you might want to take some time to either manually farm or set up an automation to get squid and lightning seeds. The final step requires a few of both. You will need transistors and capacitors for this step, three of each, blah, blah, blah. So we've actually like gone ahead and done this, but we do get now a, so that's cool. Let's quickly check this and hopefully not die. 72%, that seems as if it's taken a lot less than 5 minutes. Okay, cool. So what's next? Okay, so I haven't actually done much apart from clear up my inventory a little bit, but I just quickly wanted to make an armor stand, because I think that, oh, that's not the right thing to do. I think that, see those, the armor I'm wearing, it is heating me up a little bit, and whilst it's good and everything, where can I put this? I'll probably put it round about here. Whilst it's good and everything, it is heating me up a bit too much, I think. Oh, hold on, actually, let's, I have no idea if that just heated me up or not. Let's get a lever and a piece of cobble. And where did I put the, there it is. Okay, so let us put this on that. Let us, oh, I forgot that that was down there. That's okay still. Okay, let's put a piece of cobble here. I don't know why, I thought I wouldn't have to be able to drop it. And let's put that lever on there. Let's put a piece of dust here. And let us see, because that would allow us to shift click and change everything, what that does to temperature. Now, what are we beside that's warming us up right now? Probably these things. So that's a bit of an unfair comparison. But anyway, we're in the red. Let's try. It heats us up. Yeah, okay, so that definitely heats us up. So probably not something I want to be wearing too much of. Okay, stay away from those things as well. Is that even running? It's not even running. Anyway. Put this down here. Oh, let's eat it. So, okay. So more prep. All right, guys, we are almost finished. So I just thought I would do some of this crafting on camera for you guys. Just so you, that I am doing it, I guess. So we need one more piece of gold. And then I think, oops, we're almost ready. So first, let's make ourselves the redstone reception coil. Boom. Then let's make some of these pistons. So this is the way I tend to make pistons. Oops, daisies, didn't mean to do it like that at all. That's annoying. Bam, bang, there we go. And I say that's the way I tend to make pistons. It's just the way you make pistons, isn't it? Oh, apparently not. What? Can you not use colored planks? Okay, that's weird. Anyway, there they are. Pistons. Crafting table. There we go. Just need one of those. And that should be that. Okay, so we are ready to craft pretty much everything. The last thing I need to do is make a machine frame, which I'm coming close to being able to do. So, oh, I need the glass. I think it's two glass. There we go. Machine frame. Oh, that's the wrong one. Let us make it like so. Apparently I can't. I think it's because these things can't be shift-click in, maybe. There we go. I had enough to make two, actually. Should I make two? I think I will make two, just because then I have two. There we go. That's what I got out. Got out the right... Can't I keep pressing on the grilled cheese one? Because I got out the right number just to be on the... Just because I thought I would need one for the auto-packager, and I didn't. So that's good. And let's have that. Now, in here we have the redstone furnace, boom. The auto packager, boom. The pulverizer, boom. And the energetic infuser, awesome. So that should be that, awesome. Any reward? Ooh, interesting. Good stuff. Might use this as my primary weapon now. Okay, so what are the other things we need to do? This should be pretty straightforward, and the tin upgrade should be pretty straightforward. Ooh. Upgrade. Tin. I'm actually using silver ones over my thing, so that should be pretty straightforward. Can I use any plastic here? I think it's raw plastic, actually, I need to use, isn't it? Anyway, we've got plastics down there. So, where do I normally put my... Oh, man, I had golden nuggets somewhere. There we go. Okay, so that is... Hold on, just get the general concept. Tin, plastic, and redstone. So, two redstone... Let's get some of this tin from here. I keep about a stack in here at all times if I can. Let's get grab down. Grab some. What should I use? Let's use chopper plant seeds. Let's use two chopper and one of those. And just roughly put this in so that I know roughly what I'm doing. Gold, redstone, tin is that. Now I've got the plastic on me. I do, but I don't have a stick on me. Because I think the precision is pretty straightforward. I think it's just plastic on the top like a hammer would be. It is, which is great, because that means I just get to go like this. Boom. Awesome. One more quest. Completed. Oh, and even got one of those. Oh, awesome. Good stuff all around. And basic at E, bit harder, so I think I'll do that off camera at a later date. Yes. But this is cool, because now we have this, it means we can charge up one of these bad boys, which would be pretty nice, because these are expensive, to say the least. I don't even know where you get flux crystals. Wow. Yeah, they're expensive, so it's nice to be able to have that, two of them off the bat. I wonder if I can, like, melt it down or use it in some way. Right, so can we sleep? This actually allows us to sleep, which is really cool. For some reason, the other one was always never far enough away from monsters, but we can sleep pretty cool in this bed, so it works pretty well so far. So, I think next we shall be working on the mob farm. So, that'll be a bit of off-camera work, so I shall do that, as I said, off-camera. Let's, first of all, just put these buildings down, even if they're not going to be where they're actually going to be. Let's say, for example, let's just put them down here, 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 and here. Actually, let us get the furnace and try to semi-automate this setup. Okay, so that's getting flux, so that's good. It's also getting that because it's already set up to be input from there. Now, where do I want it to output? I want it to output down. Can it output down? It can. And that should give us some charcoal, which is going for a long time, strangely, which is interesting. And that is it getting pyre? It's difficult to tell. I don't think it is getting pyre, is it? But it might be once this is full. How much does this take? It uses 20 redstone flux per tick, and that's only given out 5 per tick, so actually that will never work, will it? That will never work. Damn it. That'll just use pyre. That'll just use pyre. Okay, so that can't work, which is a shame. I mean, now it'll gain pyre again, won't it? Or no, it won't. Anyway, we'll just leave that be, because we might have to just come down and use the ender generator on that every now and again. So in fact, let us just grab all this and grab that charcoal. That it does smelt it up pretty quickly, so that alone is pretty cool. Pop this back here. Does it still have its pyre? Of course it doesn't. And let us get to work on the mob farm, or at least on the workings of the mob farm. So be right back once I've got the tools I think I'll need.